Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone. Sing, oh praise the name. Oh praise the name of the Lord.
Designed by God, and God designed a family on purpose. And so we can see a picture of Adam and Eve, the very first family, and we see their first son Cain, and we see that God designed us with a purpose and families with a purpose. All right, so we are going to see a saying, and I want you guys to say if this was really true. You ready? Being loving to a sibling is really difficult sometimes. Do you guys agree with this? Yes. Or you disagree with this? No. Okay, thumbs up or thumbs down. Do you agree with this statement? All right. Now, I want you to see this next one. Being loving to a sibling is God's plan all the time. How about this one? Yes, this is the plan. This is how God designed family. God designed family to be loving to each other, and sometimes we're not. We're going to look at a verse in 1 John 4:7, and it says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God." So in this verse, we see that God is love and he wants us to love others. And that includes the people in our family. Now, this is God's design. This is what the Bible says. We don't just grab this out of thin air. This is God's design. It's in the Bible that we love everyone, but today we're talking about loving our family. All right, is it hard to love our brother or sister and sometimes hard to love our family? Yes. We've got another verse that talks about a different kind of family, too, that we're supposed to love. Anyone who does what my Father in heaven wants is my brother or sister or mother. All right? So we also have our church family that we're supposed to love. People who are following God, obeying God. People maybe in your parents' small group when you come to church. You know, these are people that we're supposed to love also. All right? So that was Matthew 12:50. So we're supposed to love our siblings all the time. Because does Jesus love us all the time or just some of the time? All the time. Jesus loves us all the time. And so we need to love the people in our family all the time. Even when it's hard to love the people in our family, we're supposed to do it. Remember when we talked about the name for God called Adonai? He's the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He made everything and he's over everything. Well, he designed the family that way. He designed the universe that way for us to be part of a family, whether we have a family at our house or whether we have a church family, and he designed us to love that family. Now, if you don't have any siblings in your family, like if you're an only child, you might think of people maybe in your family, maybe you have cousins who you have a hard time getting along with, or maybe friends in your neighborhood, or just different people that are around you that maybe you play with a lot or you hang out with a lot and maybe you have a hard time with them, okay? So when I'm talking about this, maybe you can think about them. Now, we're gonna look at the, hold on a second, family, first family. All right, I'm gonna draw a picture of the first family. All right, this is Adam. And then this is Eve. Okay, that's the first mom and dad. That's the first man and wife. And that's how God designed family, to have a woman and a man, and they get married, all right? And so the first kid that we see here that they have, his name is Cain. He's a boy, all right? He was there for a while. And then we have another boy. Later, she gave birth to his brother Abel. Abel took care of sheep. Cain farmed the land, Genesis 4:2. And so we're going to add Abel to this picture. It's another boy, so it's have two brothers. A third leg there. So this is the first family. You have a mom and a dad, and you have two brothers, Cain and Abel. Now, Cain had a hard time with Abel. And we've seen this from the beginning of time. Being loving towards siblings has been difficult from the beginning.
This house is so full of people, it makes me sick. When I grow up and get married, I'm living alone. Did you hear me? I'm living alone!
Okay, in the Bible we see this. We see this from the beginning of time. It's been hard for people to be loving toward their siblings. And Cain had a hard time being loving towards his siblings. Okay? In fact, Cain ended up killing his brother Abel, the very first family, and one brother killed the other brother. So this statement is true. It's hard to be loving towards either your sibling, your brother, or your sister. And sometimes it's very hard, and we see this at the very beginning. Since the beginning, it has been important to love siblings, and sometimes it doesn't happen, all right? So it matters. Now, Cain killed Abel, and then we have another incident where Joseph, this guy, he had lots of brothers, and they threw him down a well, and then they sold him. And then there was another incident of Mary and Martha, and they were sisters, and they had trouble. So this is not something new. It's happened at the very beginning where siblings had a hard time loving each other. Now, just because they have a hard time loving each other, does that mean it's okay for us to be mean? No. Okay? Do you think it mattered to God what Cain did to his brother? Yeah. Do you think it mattered how Joseph's brothers treated him? Do you think it matters what Mary and Martha fight about? Yes, it does. In fact, the Bible tells us what happened to Cain. The Lord said, "What have you done? Listen, your brother's blood is crying out to me from the ground. So I am putting a curse on you. I'm driving you away from this ground. It has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you farm the land, it will not produce its crops for you anymore. You'll be a restless person who wanders around the earth." Genesis 4, 10 through 12. God says it's not okay to be like that towards your brothers, okay? It's not okay what Cain did to his brother. It's not okay what Joseph's brothers did to him. It's not okay Mary and Martha fighting. Even though it's happened since the beginning of time, that does not mean it's okay. It matters to God if we are loving to our siblings, even when it's difficult. Now, I want you guys to go get a piece of paper right now and a pencil or a pen. Go, before I start again. Go get you a piece of paper.
5 hours later.
Now that you have your piece of paper, at the top of it, I want you to write, "It's difficult to be loving toward a sibling when." So if you don't want to say sibling, if you want to say brother or your sister, you can do that. You can say, "It's difficult to be loving toward my sister when." "It's difficult to be loving toward my brother when." Okay? So when is it difficult? And then I want you to write when it's difficult.
Holy cow! I know he's on fire. Just put him out!
What makes it difficult? Now, I'm going to tell you this while you guys are writing down what situation in your family that you have a hard time with your brother or your sister, what do they do that drives you crazy? I had two brothers. I had one that's older than me, that was 3 years older than me, and then one that was 1 year younger than me. So they're both brothers. And they were pretty good most of the time, but sometimes they would make fun of me. Sometimes they would be mean to me. And then the worst thing that I thought is they would like to wrestle, and they would pin my arms down and just tickle me. I couldn't stand that. And they wouldn't let me up, and they wouldn't stop. That made me so mad. So maybe that's something that you guys deal with, or maybe you deal with something else, but I want you to write it down. Maybe you want to play with them and they don't want to play with you. Maybe you want to be alone and they won't let you be alone. Maybe they take your stuff. Maybe they don't like you, and maybe they kick you, or they slap you, or they want your attention, or they say mean words to you. Okay? Write down what it is. It's hard to love your brother or sister when they do this. Okay? Now, when you write this, there's going to be two categories it's going to fall into. Usually it's two categories that these "I don't like my sibling because they do this" fall into. Okay, the first one is you both want something and you both can't have it at the same time. Maybe it's a remote control, maybe it's a TV, maybe it's your parents' attention. There's two things that you want that usually you can't get at the same time. Maybe that makes you crazy. Maybe it makes you have anger.
Is it okay to give them that?
I wasn't hearing any better ideas.
So here's how the Bible explains it. James 4, 1 through 3. James 4, 1 through 3. "What causes fights and quarrels among you? Don't they come from your desires that battle within you? You desire but do not have, so you kill. You covet, but you cannot get what you want, so you quarrel and fight. You do not have because you do not ask God. When you ask, you do not receive because you ask with the wrong motives, that you may spend what you get on your pleasures." Okay? So this verse talks about sometimes we get mad at our brothers or sisters because we want something. Sometimes we're selfish. Okay? Or sometimes we think it's not fair and it just gets anger inside of us. when we want something so bad. And what happens is we don't think about how God wants us to feel during that situation. All right, so let's look back at the situation. God says, shows us that wanting something and not going to God with a right heart can hurt the people around us, okay? So maybe you can talk to your brother or sister, and maybe they don't care, or maybe they don't understand, but God wants us to have a right heart, and we're gonna talk about what we can do later. All right, so that's problem number one. So problem number two is when siblings do something that hurt you or hurt one another. It might be physical, like they like to push you, or they like to kick you, or slap you, or hit you. Okay, hopefully none of that, but it does happen. Or maybe it's something that they say. The words hurt you. They call you a name. They make fun of you. They scream at you to get out. And that really hurts your feelings because the people in your family are really close to you. And when you do stuff like that, that hurts really bad. And then when you do stuff, sometimes they're like, okay, they did that to me. I'm not really gonna love them anymore. Or I really am not gonna be nice to them anymore because look how much that hurt me, what they did or what they said. And God doesn't want that. All right, so we have these two problems that all of the stuff that you guys wrote down should be following these two categories. So how can we love siblings with these two problems? All right, so we're gonna come up with a couple of solutions. So here's one solution. We should just get rid of them, right? Just like Cain, let's just get rid of them.
I made my family disappear.
Yeah! Is that a good solution? No, that's not a good solution. Most of the time we're not gonna kill them. We're not gonna throw them down a well or sell them, okay? But sometimes in our heart, we almost do the same thing. Sometimes we hate or we have so much anger in our heart that it's almost like throwing them down a well or killing them.
I hate you!
Because we are angry towards them. All right, so let's listen to what Jesus says about that. You have heard what it was said to people who lived long ago. They were told, do not commit murder. Anyone who murders will be judged for it. There's the next one. But here is what I tell you. Do not be angry with a brother or sister. Anyone who is angry with them will be judged. Again, anyone who says to a brother or sister, Raca, must stand trial in court, and anyone who says, you fool, will be in danger of the fire in hell. Matthew 5, 21 through 22. Raca means like empty-headed. And what Jesus is talking about is sometimes like, oh yeah, well, I don't really want to kill my brother, or I don't really want to throw him down a well. But in our heart, we get so angry, and we have so much hatred towards them, that almost Jesus talks about, it's almost the same thing. Or maybe we tell them to shut up, or we want them to get out, or we treat them so badly that it's almost like what Jesus is talking about. You may not murder them, but your anger and your hatred towards them is very damaging. All right, so God teaches us a better way for our siblings. Everyone who loves has become a child of God and knows God. And so this can help us. When we know God, it can help us in loving our brothers and sisters. Because there's some stuff about God that we know, and we're like, yes, I love this about God. This is so awesome about God that we need to put into our lives to help us treat the people that we love better. So let's look at a video about a situation that might be a brother or sister situation. This one's gonna be two brothers and the situation that they have that's going on.
When we know things about God, I mean really know them deep in our hearts, it can help us to be loving toward our siblings. Let's look at a few examples and see how this works. Let's say you want the TV remote and your brother wants the TV remote. You both can't have what you want and your brother always gets a hold of the remote, so it should be your turn, but your brother refuses to share. You think about what's causing the problem and you realize you want something, your brother wants something, and you can't both have what you want. That's the problem. So let's think about what we know about God. How does that change things?
All right, now in that situation, when we're watching it, what are truths about God that we could know to help this little boy, okay, with his brother and his brother's situation, with his older brother? What could we do to help them? Okay, maybe it's we could realize that God loves us and he loves our brother. And maybe instead of anger or hatred, we can do some kind things and maybe talk to our brother about, hey, can I have a turn with that? Just always things in kindness, because whenever we get anger or we have hatred and we want to hurt or we want to just be mean, that never solves anything. It never helps anything. Okay, so we need to think about what God would want us to do. God is not angry. He's not doesn't have hatred. He does things in kindness and love. And so maybe that's something that he could do with his brother. All right, we're going to watch the second video about a girl and her situation.
Okay, let's look at another situation. Let's say your big sister has stopped hanging out and playing with you so much. She's getting older, and now she doesn't want to do as much with you. You think about what's causing the problem, and you realize, honestly, your feelings are really hurt by this. So let's think about what we know about God. How does that change things?
All right, so what truth about God would be helpful in this situation? All right, maybe it'll be helpful for her to remember that God is our Father, all right, and he is perfect. Because sometimes we don't know and we don't remember when we're in a situation that really hurts our feelings. All right, so knowing the truth about God can help us in loving our siblings. So sometimes we need to think about who is God and how does he treat me? And when he treats me like this, then this is how I should treat my brother or sister or somebody in my family or my cousins or my friends. This is how God wants me to treat them, okay? We can think about how God is compassionate, how he is love, how he hears us, how he loves us and he gave us Jesus. He gives us peace. He wants to be a perfect father to us. And when we do stuff wrong, he doesn't just kick us out or throw us down a well. You know, he gives us a second chance and he loves us. And that's what we need to remember. That's what God wants us to remember when we have hatred or we're angry toward our sibling or we find things that are hard. We need to think about how God loves us so that we can love our siblings that way. So what I want you to do is flip over your piece of paper from a while ago. And I want you to write down something about God that could help you in this situation. So you look at the situation that you wrote on the front. How is it hard to be difficult to a brother or sister? And I want you to think about on the back, okay, what is something about God that can help me during this situation? So it could be what we just talked about, how he's compassionate and loving, how he gives us a second chance, how he hears us, how he gave us Jesus, he gives us the people in our lives. Maybe write down some of those. What is something that you know about God and how he treats you that you could treat your brother and sister with that same kind of love?
Hey, Kev. It's pretty cool that you didn't burn the place down.
Thanks, Buzz.
All right. I want you to write that right now. And then I'm going to pray for you. And then when this is over, I want you to pray for your brother or sister or whoever you thought about when you wrote on that paper, piece of paper, because it's really hard sometimes. God, we thank you so much for all you give us. We thank you that we're designed by you and our family, and we know that we have to love you because you are so great. We thank you so much for giving us your son Jesus and how much love you are and your perfect father. You give us peace. You hear us. You give us second chances, and all that should show us you treat us so well, Lord, and help us to treat others the same way, especially our brother or sister who drives us crazy. Help us to treat them with love and kindness instead of hatred and anger, and help us to pray when we have that situation happen, and help us to go and talk to you in prayer when the situation happens. We love you so much, Lord. In your name I pray. Amen.
Hey, boys and girls, it's Cam here. Hey, just before we wrap up and end today's service with you guys as preteens, we want to remind you about the Compassion Kids. We picked up another child, which is going to be on your screen. You'll be able to see them. But also, I just want to challenge you to maybe set a penny bank aside, your allowance or any kind of money that you get from doing any kind of odd jobs around the house. I'm sure you have a lot of time right now. because you're at home a lot and hanging out. We just want to make sure that our compassion kids are not forgot about, because it's easy to do. So I know even in the morning show for you to your parents, we talked, Keith and Emily talked about the compassion kids and how important they are to give to those kids. So when we come back to church, we're going to have a big celebration. We're going to have a lot of pictures of you guys watching these Bible stories that we've been teaching and lessons we've been teaching, but also we're going to celebrate the offering for our compassion kids. So, hey, I pray you guys have a great week. We're praying for you. We don't want to forget about you. You guys are on our hearts and our minds. We're just getting excited to come back together like you wouldn't believe. We'd like you to come back today. So anyway, pray you have a great week. We'll talk to you guys later.